Hi friends. Hi friends. Good afternoon, one and all. And warm welcome our BYK College online lecture series. Today, I start our bookkeeping and accountancy's second chapter. Accounts of not-for-profit concern. That means NPO. Myself, Mrs. Sheetal Kaviraj Jadhav, account teacher of BYK College. Today is our first lecture, second chapter's first lecture. This is the portion in our second chapter. In this chapter, all of you learn this one. These all the points one by one. First one, intro, then meaning of not for profit concern. Differences between profit organization and not for profit organization. Then after explaining meaning of receipt and payment account. Features of receipt and payment account. Then types of receipt, types of payments, specimen of receipt and payment. Then next account is income and expenditure account. That accounts features, specimen, explain you. Then distinguish between receipt and payments account and income and expenditure account. Then how to prepare income and expenditure account. So that means in this chapter, two accounts is important. We prepare income and expenditure. Receipt and payment account is your question. And then after, we prepare income and expenditure account. Then prepare balance sheet. Then I explain you important adjustment, specimen of balance sheet, additional information and important terms. So this chapter is remember very, very important. And this chapter is the scoring topic, a scoring chapter. Because in these chapters, my main important question, that means problem of NPO for 12 marks. And these 12 marks in this question, nothing or question. So that means this is the compulsory question, remember. And in the board paper pattern, question number 6, NPOs for 12 marks. And 4 marks for the objective type question. So this chapter is very important and it's a compulsory. Okay. So now I start one by one. Intro. Two types of the organization, student. First one, trading organization. That is also called the profit making organization. And second one is the non-trading, not for profit organization or service organization. So, trading organization and non-trading organization. Both are the different organization, remember. Trading organization, for example, last chapter, all of you learned that partnership final account, right? In that chapter, all of you prepare trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. So that means partnership firm is a, yes, trading organization. Remember, profit making organization. So trading organizations, listen here, main objective to earn profit. And not for profit organization, main aim is the, yes, service oriented. Yeah, give the services. Non trading means not for profit organization. For example, just like BYK college means college, school, university is the example of not for profit concern. Charitable trust, hospital, temples, sports club, these all is the example of the not for profit organization. And these organizations main aim is the provide services, not earn profit. Remember. Meaning and definition of not for profit organization. Maybe ask the question, answer in one sentence. What do you mean by not for profit concern? An organization which undertakes various activities without any profit motive by services, society or general public is called a not-for-profit organization, not-for-profit concern. Yes, is it clear now? Yes, this is the definition of not-for-profit concern. Not-for-profit concern also called the service organization, also called social welfare charity. The objective of this organization is not to earn profit but to give services. Remember, they never engage in trading activities. This is the meaning of NPO, which are formed for promoting commerce, arts, promoting arts, science, religion, charity, or any other useful object. We spend their income in promoting their object. They prohibit the payment of any dividend to their members. So that means they cannot give the dividend of our members, because this is not the profit for organization. This is the non-profit organization. That's why they not given dividends. Yeah, they prohibit the dividend. Whose primary motive is to provide services to its members and not to earn profit. Yes, all of you understood what's the meaning of not-for-profit concern? Okay, good. Then next. It is the differences between profit organization and not-profit organization. Profit organization's main motive is the profit motive, and not-for-profit organization's motive is the service, give the services. Sole proprietorship, partnership firm or company is the example of profit organization. And not-for-profit organizations, for example, sports club, all the clubs, trust, public hospitals, society, school, colleges is the example of not-for-profit organization. Profit organization sell the goods and services and collect the money and earn the profit. But not for profit organization, how to collect the money? How to collect the fund? Donation, through the donation, subscription, membership fees, etc. Then after I explain you each and every terms one by one. Then this one, that means profit organization, capital contributed by the owners. So that means company, proprietorship, partnership firm collect the capital by the owners. And here it is funds from donation, subscription, government grant is important, government grant also, and so on. So this is the differences between profit organizations. Already I told you the main primary object to earn profit. And not-for-profit organization's main objective is to provide services, remember. Profit organizations prepare trial balance, trading, profit and loss account and balance sheet. But not-for-profit organizations do not prepare trial balance, remember, but they prepare receipt and payment account, income and expenditure account and balance sheet. Profit organizations net result. So that means profit organization, why prepare this trading account, a trial balance, profit and loss account? Because find out the net profit or net loss. Capital reserve, surplus, yeah, that means the financial statement. They find out all this one. Oh, profit organization. So profit organization's net result is the net profit, net loss, yeah, financial statement. But not-for-profit organization's net result is the find out the surplus or deficit. Is it clear now? So that means NPO means not-for-profit organization not find out the profit and loss, because that the main motto, your main objective is to, yes, to provide services, not to earn profit. So that's why NPO net result, you find out the surplus or deficit. What's the meaning surplus and deficit? Then after I explain you one by one. So is it clear now? What's the differences between profit organization and not-for-profit organization? Yes? Is it clear now? Okay, good. Then next one. Not-for-profit organizations main books of accounts. First one, receipt and payment account. Second one, income and expenditure account. And third one, balance sheet. So that means when we solve the problem of NPO, so this account and this statement is important, remember. Then after I explain you what's the meaning of income, yeah, what's the meaning of balance sheet, yeah, receipt and payment account. So all of you watch each and every slide, each and every video, so your doubt has been clear. Then when you solve the problem, so you can easily solve the problem of NPO. What's the need? Yeah, why we prepare these books? Yeah, what's the need for maintaining books of accounts? Because of to maintain proper control over monetary transaction. Jitne bhi monetary transactions hai, वो उसमें क्या हो जाता है, कंट्रोल होता है, यानी कि आपने को आइडिया आ जाती है. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज टू नो द सोर्सेस ऑफ इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर. टू नो सरप्लस है डेफिसिट, मींस सरप्लस हुआ है या डेफिसिट, मींस इनकम ज्यादा हुआ है या एक्सपेंडिचर, सो वी कैन फाइंड इजीली. टू नो द नेटवर्क of the concern as on particular day, to avoid malpractices and misappropriations of cash and assets. So that means we can easily find out this one also, and we find out, yes, to comply with the provisions of laws applicable to them. For example, not-for-profit concern register as a charitable trust under Mumbai Public Trust Act, or cooperative society under Cooperative Societies Act has to comply with the provisions of these acts regarding budget, audit of accounts and register to be maintained, etc. So this is the need. Why we prepare the books of accounts? Yeah, why we maintain the books of account? Is it clear now? Okay, good. then next. So already I told you the three types of accounts. I explained you one by one: receipt and payment account, then after income expenditure and balance sheet. This is the first account, receipt and payment account. Yes. What's the meaning of receipt? All receipts during a particular period are debited to receipt and payment account. So that means when we draw the receipt and payment account, in the debit side, what we write down? All receipts during a particular period. And in respect of the year for which they are received, and in respect of their nature, revenue or capital. Remember, receipt and payment accounts when we draw, so in that time, we all the receipt means nature, or in which receipt, revenue or capital receipt, both are the write down in the debit side. Such receipts may be related to the previous year, current year or next year. समझ में आ रहा है मैं क्या बोल रही हूँ? When we draw the receipt side, so where we write down receipt, all the receipt, that means revenue receipt or capital receipts. These receipts may be previous year, means last year, or current year, means in this year or next years. All the receipts given in the debit side. So all receipts are debited to this account. And next side is the payment side. All payments made during a particular period are credited to receipt and payment account. So that means receipt debited and payment credited in this account. In respect of the period to which it related, and in respect of their nature, revenue or capital. Both are the payments given, revenue or capital. Then after I explain you one by one, what's the meaning of revenue or capital. Such payments may be related to previous year, last year, current year, means this year and next year. Remember student, if you are given 3 years, so first you see, in which year is the previous year, in which year is the current year and next year. So if you find out this one, so automatically you can solve the problem easily. Remember, such payments may be revenue or capital. Remember this one also. All are credited to this account. Samajh mein aaya? This account, receipt side debited, payment side credited. All the sources of receipt, for example, revenue receipt, subscription, collect the subscription, entrance fees, donations, sale of old newspaper, income from investment. This all is the revenue receipt. And capital receipt means, for example, life membership fees, specific donation, sale of old assets and investment, legacy and endowment fund is sources of a receipt. Next point is the features of receipt and payment account. Remember student, receipt and payment account is a real account. Maybe this point is important for your maybe objective type question, true and false, yeah, filling the blanks. So if you ask the question, receipt and payment account is a nominal account? No, this account is a real account. Okay. So yes, anybody tell me what's the real account rule? Last year, 11th class, yes. All of you learned that, all the rules. Yes, tell me what's the real account rule? Yes, debit what comes in, and yes, credit what goes out. Good. remember, receipt and payment account is a similar to cash book. Summary of cash and bank transaction. Last year, all of you learned that cash book. So that means receipt and payment account is a similar to cash book. It includes all types of receipts and payments. That means revenue or capital also. It records all receipts and payments made during a particular period. Particular period, that means already I told you current year, your previous year, your next year. Income receivable and amounts payable are not recorded in this account. Remember. This account is based to prepare final account of not-for-profit concern. So that means this account is your question. For example, last chapter when you prepare a trading profit and loss and balance sheet, so in that time trial balance is your question. And here it is, receipt and payment account is your question, and then after you prepare income and expenditure account and balance sheet. So that means this account is a base to prepare final accounts of not for profit concern. Okay. This account shows opening and closing balances of cash and bank account. So that means when start, you have been draw this account, first one in this debit side, first given a opening cash or bank balance, and last one in the payment side given the cash or bank balance. Remember, means opening and closing balances of cash and bank balance. Next, types of receipt. Already I told you two types, capital receipt and revenue receipt. Capital receipt means all such receipts are non-recurring in nature. Remember this one. Not forming a part of regular flow of income of concern are known as capital receipt. So that means capital receipt, a capital income, in this income is not a regular flow. For example, specific donation for building, sports tournaments, library, life membership fees, sales proceeds of fixed assets. Capital receipts are either added to capital fund or separately show on the liability side of balance sheet. When we solve the problem of NPO, when we draw the balance sheet, when we prepare the balance sheet, in that time, where we write down the capital fund, balance sheets, the liability side, yeah, otherwise capital receipts are added to capital fund or separately show on the liability side of balance sheet. Next receipt is the revenue receipt. First one capital receipt, second one revenue receipt. All such receipts which are recurring in nature. Recurring in nature means represent regular flow of income, known as revenue receipt. For example, subscription rent, locker rent, interest received. So that means this is the monthly receipt, yeah, yearly receipt. Okay, so all of you understood capital receipt and revenue receipt. So what you understand? Yes, revenue receipt credit side of income and expenditure account, and capital receipts, liability side of balance sheet. समझ में आ रहा है मैंने क्या बोला? कैपिटल रिसीट कहां पर लिखते हैं हम? लायबिलिटी साइड ऑफ बैलेंस शीट, एंड रेवेन्यू रिसीट क्रेडिट साइड ऑफ इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट. ट्रांसफर टू देयर, दैट मींस इनकम एक्सपेंडिचर्स क्रेडिट साइड, कैपिटल रिसीट लायबिलिटी साइड ऑफ बैलेंस शीट. This is the example of capital receipt. Capital receipt means amount received from sale of non-current assets or from long-term borrowings. Long-term, remember, capital means long-term. For example, sale of old factory machinery. Sale of old factory equipment, yeah, sale of old office furniture, sale of motor vehicle. So this is the example of capital receipt. Okay, here it is, we sell out all the assets, fixed asset for example, sale of business property. Okay, but if we have sale of newspaper, so that not the capital receipt, huh? Remember, that's the revenue receipt. Amount received from long term, capital receipts means this amount, yes, from long term benefit. Amount received from long term bank loans also. Amount received from mortgage. Amount received as a specific donation or non-recurring receipt in the business. Isn't it clear now? All the example of related to the capital receipt. This is the expenditure. Heavy vehicle, office furniture, office equipment, office property, plant and machinery. So that means all is the related to the capital receipt and capital expenditure. So receipt account is clear, and now payment, types of payments. Capital expenditure, revenue expenditure and deferred revenue expenditure. These three types of the payments. Receipt two types and payments three types. Receipts, capital receipt bola maine, revenue receipt bola, but here it is three types of the payments: capital expenditure, revenue expenditure and deferred revenue expenditure. So I explain you one by one. See here, listen carefully. What's the meaning of capital expenditure? These expenditure are non-recurring expenditure in nature. Remember, the benefit of such expenditure are likely to be received for long period. These expenses are shown on the asset side of balance sheet. And their balances are carried forward to next accounting period. Next expenditure is the revenue expenditure. Yes. These expenses are recurring in nature. Recurring nature means are enjoyed immediately, means current year. Capital expenditure means long period, more than 1 year, 2 year, or 5 years and more than. But revenue expenditure means enjoy immediately, yeah, current year. Deferred revenue expenditure, third type is the payments. Deferred revenue expenditure is actually revenue expenditure. But this expenditure is for receiving benefit for more than a year. So that means revenue expenditure enjoy immediately a current year in this year, but these expenditures benefit for more than a year. For example, advertisement expenditure paid rupees 30,000 is for 3 years. यानी कि एडवर्टीजमेंट के लिए हमने क्या किया है, 3 years के लिए 30,000 पे किया है. इन सच केस 1/3 ऑफ 30,000 मीन्स कितना हुआ, 10,000 इज फॉर करंट ईयर. इट शुड बी डेबिटेड टू इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर. सो यानी कि उससे पहले क्या करना पड़ेगा अपने को, फर्स्ट वी फाइंड आउट, 3 years का पे किया है सो 1 year का फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट करना है और कहाँ लिखना है, डेबिटेड टू इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट. एंड 2/3 मीन्स रुपीज 20,000 एक्सपेंडिचर शुड बी शो ऑन द एसेट साइड ऑफ बैलेंस शीट बिकॉज दिस इज द प्रीपेड एक्सपेंसेस. प्रीपेड मीन्स पेड इन एडवांस, यानी कि 3 years का पे किया है सो 1 year का अपने को फर्स्ट इनकम एक्सपेंडिचर में दिखाना है और 2 years का प्रीपेड है इसलिए कहा जाएगा बैलेंस शीट के एसेट साइड में. सो टोटल पेमेंट्स रेवेन्यू डेबिट साइड ऑफ इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट वेयर वी शो डेबिट साइड ऑफ इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट. And capital payments, balance sheets, asset side. Yes, all of you understood what's the meaning of receipts and payments. Is it clear now? Okay, good. Next video, I taught you next point. So that means income and expenditure account.